Morning Mavericks. Today is Thursday, September 27, 2018. I'm Chance Latimer.
And I'm Braden Holstein, and these are your morning announcements.
NHS members, please remember that our Call-A-Fun fundraiser will take place this Friday, September 28th, in Portable 7B. Please arrive at lunch for pizza, and don't forget to bring your call list.
Seniors, Jostens will be having a meeting with you in the auditorium October 2nd, 9:30 a.m. Please check in with your teacher, then come down to the auditorium that day.
Yearbooks are available for purchase for $65 online through yearbookcenter.com and enter code 7808 or the bookkeeper before school, at lunch, or after school. Get yours reserved today.
This week's football game against Centennial, upon their request, has been changed to a purple out. Last year, a teacher passed away from pancreatic cancer, and they have dedicated this game to him. They have asked us to help support them and come together in unity by wearing purple to this week's football game. Hey, I heard we had some weather.
Let's slide it over to Zane.
Thanks, guys. Zane here with your wicka wicka weather. It is currently 45 degrees right now, and it plans on getting to be 82, so make sure you stay warm until then. Thanks, and back to you.
Thank you, Zane, for that weather.
Yeah, thank you. Are you interested in joining the military or just wanting to take your career aptitude test? The ASVAB test is being offered here at the school on Tuesday, October 2nd from 1:30 to 4:30. Please go to the Career Center to sign up no later than tomorrow.
The 12th Annual Hispanic Leadership Summit will be held at BSU on October 24th. If you are interested in attending this event, please see Ms. Mandarez in room 308 or Counselor Julie Netz in the counseling office.
School picture retakes are Monday, October 1st. Bring your picture packet with you to give back to the photographers. Senior tux and drape photos are Thursday and Friday, October 11th and 12th during senior English classes.
Senior dedications are able to reserve and design online at yearbookordercenter.com with the add button. Yearbook will host a design night on October 23rd from 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. for help with the progress.
There will be a short meeting for all baseball players today at the beginning of lunch in the lecture hall.
There will be a boys basketball meeting Monday, October 1st in room 211 at 11:20 a.m. during lunch. If you are interested in trying out, you need to be there. If you are in another sport meeting, please stop by to find out what you missed. See Coach Nettleton if you have any questions.
Root of Bible study every Thursday at lunch in Mariah's room G4. It looks like we have a teacher of the week.
Let's go check it out.
Hey Matt, I'm here with Mr. Wynn, and this is your teacher of the week. So what's your favorite part about teaching speech?
Oh, there's a lot of things I love about teaching speech. Getting to know my students, that's the best thing, that I have the opportunity to hear a lot of presentations where the kids talk about their interests and hobbies, and once you get to know students better and they get to know me better, it just forms a better atmosphere, I think.
That's awesome. Did you always want to be a teacher?
I really didn't. I never thought I'd be a teacher. I was pretty shy and quiet in high school, and one of my jobs was teaching tennis, and I started teaching high school tennis while I was going to college, and I thought, this is kind of fun, and I really started to get to know, you know, my players and got to know my students, and it was fun, so I liked that, the age group, high school age group.
So as a teacher, what's your motto for life?
Well, I'll have to be real with you, I had to steal a motto. There's a gentleman that I actually show a video in speech class, a gentleman that's paralyzed from the neck down, and one of his mottos is, every day above ground is a good day, so I'm just happy to be here.
Mm-hmm. Okay, what's your favorite thing to do on your free time?
I basically have two jobs, teaching speech and then going home and taking care of my dog, because he's pretty much full time. I have to take him on two and a half hour walks, if not, he whines all day, all evening, and it's ridiculous, so he's pretty spoiled.
He's spoiled. So what does grit mean to you?
To me, grit means when you have those days where you just don't want to get out of bed and life seems terrible and you got issues going on, it's just to roll on and struggle through and just realize, hey, I can make it. And that just makes you become a better person, I think, to overcome those things.
Peace.
Thank you for what you do, Mr. Wynn.
Yeah, thanks for all your hard work. That's all for your morning announcements, Maz. If you have any more, please send them in to cable14@hotmail.com before first period.
Please stand for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag.
Take a chance on me. If you need me, let me know. Gonna be around. If you got no place to go when you're feeling down.